Oh! Get one of these. That's a nice move, right? That's a nice move. Can I have some of this? Bada bing, bada boom, boom. Bada bing, bada boom, boom, boom.
What is up, guys? It is Trusted Critics here. I'm Zachary Rusin, and I'm joined by my co-host, Danny Chamberlain. And we're ready to listen to some fresh new tunes.
We sure are. First up, we're going to have a song called How You Like That by Blackpink.
Blackpink? Dropping some
yes,
fresh?
Yes, they got some new stuff out. These guys have been around since 2016, from my understanding. They're a girl group from South Korea.
Yes.
They're really got big things popping. So
yes, they're signed with the YG Entertainment label, not to be confused with BTS's label. There's actually some friction there. These groups are like very much factory fed. Obviously, it's a huge industry in South Korea, and these guys have the number one, I think it's the fastest 24-hour single on YouTube ever. So they blew this shit off. Yeah. But the fact is, yeah, I mean, they're like these factory systems where they like build their Instagrams and everything very specific to these groups, and then they're very competitive.
Yeah.
And I guess they got some new shit.
Yes, they do. I mean, I'm still trying to catch up with the K-pop wave, so this will be great for me. I need to kind of figure out what this is all about and what is with the hype. So without further ado.
Well, let's see, because it's the first song here is called How You Like It. So let's see, Dan, how you like. They always have, you know, those really wavy beats that I really love, but I think the best part of K-pop is the music video. So you gotta hope this song really blows the hell up, because then we get a ridiculous music video. Have you seen the music videos, Dan?
Oh, well, that's really funny, because it looks like they have a music video out. I think we might as
well. They just dropped?
We might as well watch it. We might, while we're, let's go ahead and watch it, right? I mean, God.
If you haven't seen a K-pop music video, welcome to the craziest experience of your life. I have a feeling before even watching, we're gonna be going through space, we're gonna be going underwater, we're gonna be blowing shit up, it's gonna be provocative, it's everything in one video.
Yeah, absolutely, I'm really excited to see this. Let's dive right in, huh?
Mm-hmm. What the fuck is that? In your area.
Oh, okay. Okay, girls.
Dude, I called it. They're already underwater.
Underwater, yep. Wavy. Ooh, hit them with the light.
Yeah, dude, the budget for a music video for K-pop is like millions, dude.
Yeah, the wind, just constant wind. It's a freaking tornado. Oh! Get one of these. That's a nice move. Can I have some of this?
Bada bing, bada boom, boom.
Bada bing, bada boom, boom, boom.
Bing, bong, bing, bong, bing, bong, bong.
Bada bing, bong, boom,
bong. Look at me. Look at you. Look at you.
Nah, look at me. Oh, where are they at now?
Right now?
They're like Dubai.
That's what I'm saying, Jay.
It's like traveling through space, time, every reality you could ever ask for in one video.
Everywhere at once.
What is this? Now we're in space. We're in space with umbrellas everywhere.
Mm-mm. Ooh, sparks fly.
How you like that? How you like that?
It's oil rigs in hell.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
That?
Like that? Yeah.
Look at me.
Now look at me.
You, now look at me. Look at you. Now look at me. Look at you. Now look at me.
Look at you. Now look at me. Look at you. It must be sponsored by Chanel, because we've got a mad Chanel product in this video.
Ooh.
It's a.
Oh my.
It's a
up tempo. Pick up the tempo.
It's a K-pop hit.
Doom, 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 doom. I know these words. Oh, man, my heart rate is up. It's way up.
Yeah, what the hell? I feel like I just burned 2,000 calories. I wasn't even in that music video, and I'm already tired.
Yes.
And, I mean, can we just talk about the fact that not a single goddamn thing made sense, and there's no words on the planet that could have been said, even if we did understand them, that could have justified that level of what do you call that? What do you call that, Dan?
That was, it was a trip. It was kind of like a dream I had last night where I was in 12 places in 5 minutes. You know, I was in 17 different outfits and I suddenly knew how to dance in large choreographed groups and the lighting was just prime. And I do like that. How do I like that? I like that. Okay, so to answer their question, good stuff. Is it the kind of thing I would just like throw on casually in the car? Absolutely not. I'm trying not to make that the vibe every single day, but it gets me up, it gets me going, and it's definitely some Soul Cycle shit, you know? I would be cranking out those RPMs to this song, you know?
Yeah, you know, it's really interesting with a lot of these international groups. I only say international in the fact that, like, obviously we're hearing this over in the US, but with a lot of these groups, it's like, we don't understand a lot of the words, but they always throw in something we understand, especially with K-pop, like, how you like that. That's their main line. And it's interesting, like groups like, you know, Pitbull, J Balvin, like they all kind of do this. Like they have their native language and then they like throw in a couple lines. Anita does this so that it's like really worldly, like we can understand it pretty much everywhere. And I just think that's really interesting. It's such a machine. Like they know how to break into the American market with these things, especially with like an English title. And then just hitting like those words that everybody can get behind, even if the rest of the song, we have no idea what's going on.
Yeah.
And so I just think that's genius.
No, it's so true. I mean, you're seeing a lot more of that in the last 10 years, I would say. The 2010 through 20 span was a lot of that bridging the gap between America and the other countries. Bailando, Despacito, you had Gangnam Style. They all really broke the mold. And I think the commonality was the chorus. Yeah, how you like that. It's, you know, and then they have doom, doom, doom. These are words I can say. These are words I know. I know doom, doom, bop, bop, bop. So I can sing along.
I don't think those are even words, Dan. I mean, that's the thing. Like, some of those things, like, I do wonder. I'm like, okay, so if I got the translation of this song, there's no way that there's any words in Korean that are like doom, doom, bop. Like, it's just not possible. So
potential. I'm not sure.
Yeah, maybe.
Yes. So this is my really raw reaction just because I'm really, I'm very much beginner level K-pop, but I don't know. I'm intrigued enough to want to see more. The thing is, there's no story to this. I love a good story, and this is just like anti-story. It's more just like how much visual flash can we bring? How much flair? How much money can we use on sets without actually thinking about a storyline? I'd love to see if they can bring that into the culture. I'm not sure if that's a part of the thing in K-pop. I've seen a lot of these dances. I'm not sure if they're big on like the storytelling with these.
Well, that's what I'm curious about too, because the thing is, like, also when you have a budget like this, I mean, so many artists would kill for this. Even like, you know, popular musicians now, like Billie Eilish, you know, JT, like all these artists are coming out with pretty fire music videos. The budget is, it's actually like less than this, I feel like. And so it is a little weird to me. I think you're right. It's kind of like an anti-theme. It's almost like, what are the most provocative images we can give of these guys that pretty much leave it open-ended? But I kind of leave thinking like, wow, that was crazy. Wow, that was good music. But I'm not like, oh man, I want to watch this again. Mm-hmm. Or like, I want to reinvest, or like, what am I missing here?
Yes.
It's more like, wow, that was crazy. And we all knew it was crazy, but why?
Yeah.
Why was it like that?
I think this video kind of knows its role. So it's not going to be a sit down and really consume it for most people. I think it's kind of designed for the club. You know, it's one of those visualizers that's flashing and it almost creates party lights just in your face by the nature of the shooting. So it's not, I don't think it's designed for that casual sit down. I think it's to jump around and, you know, drink Kool-Aid.
Yeah, drink the Kool-Aid. Drink the, not Kool-Aid. The Kool-Aid.
I'm drinking the K-pop Kool-Aid.
Like that?
I'm in.
All right, Dan, so we heard the new song. What is your rate of this? Out of 10, what do you give it?
Yeah, I'm going to go with a 7. It's popping. It's banging. It really gets me going. My heart was jumping, but you know, there's just something lackluster about the story or the lack thereof.
Yeah, what story?
Yeah.
Personally, I look at the video and I agree with you. I say, you know what, that's the style of K-pop. It's still, I like it a lot. I love listening to it and watching it one time. I'm not gonna binge watch this like every day, but when it comes to the song, it bumps for me. So I'm gonna go with an 8.
I wanna hear what the fans think. Did you guys enjoy it?
Yes.
What do you guys think about this?
Oh, and Dan is new to the K-pop sensation, but I am not, and I am definitely a Blackpink fan. So I know that you guys are diehards out there. I wanna hear from you guys as well. I'm a fan, liked it, didn't love it. So I wanna hear what you think too. So put that in the comments, please.
Yeah.
Like and please subscribe so we can keep making content for you.
Much love, guys. Thank you for watching.
Yes, love you guys, we'll see you soon.